Hey everyone, welcome to React course. In this lesson, we are going to understand React declarative over imperative style. In the previous lesson, we had learned the benefit of React. In that topic, we learned simplicity benefit, but what makes React simple than the other frameworks. So in this lesson, we will briefly understand what is the difference between declarative over imperative style and understand simplicity of React. These two major concepts need to be clear before you dive into React application. So, we will understand what is declarative over imperative style. Declarative style, it means developer write how it should be, not how to do. On the other hand, imperative style, developer write how to do. In the imperative style, developer define a task step by step. Now, the better choice to use in your code is a declarative style, because simplicity is always better. Simplicity is closely related to the KISS principle. KISS stands for Keep It Simple Stupid. The gist is that simple system works better. But why declarative style a better choice? The benefit is that declarative style makes your code simple, reduce complexity, and makes your code easier to read and understand. Now let's take a look at small difference between declarative and imperative style. This example illustrates the difference between declarative and imperative style. For example, let's say you have an array and you want to double the array element and store in the new array. So you will just create a simple array and a blank array here. In this situation, you can use for loop to iterate over an array and multiply by 2 and store in the new array, like this. Right? So this for loop will iterate each array element and multiply by 2 and store in the new array element on iindex. So if I just say console.log and print this array on the console, then the result would look like this. Right? This program illustrates imperative programming, and it works. Due to the complexity of the code, it is too difficult to understand what is the end result is supposed to be when you have too many imperative statements. Fortunately, you can rewrite the code using declarative style. We are going to get the same outcome using the map method. A map method creates a new array with the result of calling a function for every array element. And map method calls the provided function once for each element in an array in order. Right? So I will just get the same outcome using this code. So I will just use map function here and specify function as an argument. Right, and multiply each array element by 2. When you execute this declarative statement, you will get the same outcome. The double array is same as in the previous example. Now, you tell me which code is easier to read and understand. In my humble opinion, the declarative style is more readable and easy to understand. Right? Till now, you had seen only JavaScript code. But what about React? React takes the same declarative approach when you compose UIs. In React, to create a component, we are using declarative style. Now, I hope you understand what is the difference between declarative and imperative style. Now we will move forward to the next topic and understand React abstraction. React has a powerful abstraction of document model. React hides underlying interfaces and provide a synthetic method and properties. For example, when you create onClick event in React, the event handler will receive not a native browser-specific event object, that is a wrapper around a native event object. You can expect the same behavior from the synthetic object. React also has a set of synthetic events for touch events, which are great for building web apps for mobile devices. To describe everything about React in single lesson is not possible for anyone. I hope you understand what is the difference between declarative and imperative style and the basic understanding of React abstraction. Don't hesitate to confer your question. I hope you understand this lecture. Answering the question specified in the comment will definitely help you to remember this topic more easily. That is all for now. We will see you in the next lecture.